students. Today we're going to be looking at this account here on TikTok. It's called Not That Vegan Teacher Again. And another name for it is Stop Exploiting Animals. Let's scroll down over here and let's listen to the first video.
Being vegan means being the change you want to see in the world. So share this song, be better.
All right, so what do we have here? We have an ad for being vegan. We have a sign here that says milk is for baby cows, and we have a plate full of nutritious food, along with some soy milk here, which actually the label changes soy milk to rice milk, oat milk, and so on. So far, what do you guys think? Look okay to you? Looks okay to me.
Bear milk is for baby bears. Sheep milk is for baby sheep. Pig's milk is for baby pigs, and cow's milk it's for baby cows. Stop stealing it from them. Go vegan.
Here's this person talking about going vegan and not stealing from others. That seems okay to me. I like the sort of arm movement thing there and trying to point at the different stuffed animals in the background. Yeah, that was kind of cool.
Bear milk is for baby bears.
Sheep milk
in the background. Is for baby sheep. Pig's milk is for baby pigs. And cow's milk is for baby cows. Stop stealing it from them. Go vegan.
And what does it say on her shirt?
Bear milk.
End the animal holocaust. Well, that's right, because the animal holocaust is still going on. The actual holocaust never ended for the animals. Other people were liberated, but the animals continue to die by the billions. And if we count the fish in the sea and the whales, sharks, and dolphins, it is by the trillions. This is a reminder to you to watch the documentary called Seaspiracy. Seaspiracy, you can find it on Netflix. Also on Netflix is another great documentary called Cowspiracy. So I encourage you to watch both Cowspiracy and Seaspiracy.
Happy birthday to you. Nobody belongs in a zoo, although you kind of look like a monkey. But since you're vegan, I know that's a compliment to you. Happy birthday! Hey!
So, vegans don't get upset when they're compared to animals because we consider it to be a compliment. If somebody says that I look like a heifer, that's okay with me. I don't mind. I don't mind being compared to any kind of animal because animals are not the ones polluting the earth. They only eat what they have to eat. Animals are not overweight like us. Animals don't throw candy wrappers out of the window of their cars. Animals don't idle their engines waiting to get food at McDonald's. Animals are perfect. Okay, granted, if I was God and if I was to create the world, would I really create lions that hurt zebras? No, I would probably make a few modifications. But the thing is, lions will watch a whole group of zebras go by if they're full. They won't just randomly attack them or try to gather them up and put them through a lifetime of confinement in a Holocaust-like camp. Lions don't do that. They eat what they need to eat, and then they move on. And they don't have consciousness like we do, although they have feelings. And all animals deserve to be protected by us. We are in an ecosystem with them. Animals are not here for us on the planet. They are here with us as our companions. There's no such thing as the circle of life because we are all interconnected. It's like a giant tangled ball. We all need each other, and without the oceans, we also, all of us die because of the oxygenation that goes on in there, and everything is so connected. Please, again, watch Seaspiracy to understand everything that's going on, overfishing, and how we should stop eating all animals. We must learn to live in harmony on this planet.
Look in the mirror and sing this song, sing. I will be brave, I'll be vegan from now on. Look in your heart and sing this song, sing. I will be brave, I'll be vegan from now on. Eat only healthy vegan things. Never eat anyone's arms, legs, or wings. Don't eat anyone who has ears or eyes. Make sure when you eat that nobody cries. Break old habits you had for years. Save animals from so much terror and tears. Train yourself to always be in the mood to only buy healthy vegan food.
Declare it, I'll be vegan from now on. Declare it, put your hand on your heart,
and sing it loudly too.
That seems like a great song. Look at this. Why love one but eat the other? Look at these messages here. Right? And did you see all of the documentaries that were recommended? Now, these songs can be found under That Vegan Teacher Miss Katie. They are on Spotify, and anytime you want to do videos on TikTok, you can just go to the sounds and type in That Vegan Teacher Miss Katie, and a ton of songs will come up, and you can click on them and you can make videos with them. And in fact, more songs are coming. About another 25 are coming very soon for album number 2.
There's 2 perspectives when it comes to veganism. Veganism is the hardest thing in the world when you think about yourself. And veganism is the easiest thing in the world when you place yourself in the victim's position and think about the suffering of the animals.
I hate to break it to you, but you're kidding yourself.
Okay. Really?
There's 2 perspectives.
So there you go. Here's a young man. His name is Hudson Tarlow. He is on YouTube and he is an ethical vegan and he is saying everything that makes sense. Of course. If you're selfish and you think about yourself, you're going to be like, oh, it's so hard to be vegan, poor me. But if you think about the animals, you think, okay, this is no problem. They are suffering so much more than I am. My taste buds are not as important as their lives. And so I will find other things to eat. Right? We can all do that. It's not that hard. It's not that hard to live a life of compassion. We all need to be better and to be vegan. It's an absolute moral baseline when we know what happens to these innocent animals. Please watch Dominion Movement to understand what goes on. You can just Google it. Watchdominion.com. Thousands of people have told me that when they saw this documentary that it changed their lives. That they watched me talking and talking and talking and it was sort of like going in one ear and out the other. And when they saw a documentary called WatchDominion.com, type it in, WatchDominion.com, all one word, that is when it really hit them and they understood. And that's when they write me messages and then say, okay, I'm so sorry, Miss Katie, I didn't realize what was happening.
I hate to break it to you, but you're kidding yourself. Really, watch Dominion, watch what really happened.
Again, another person recommending Watch Dominion. Save animals by becoming a vegan animal rights activist. Be the love you want to see in the world. This world. This gentleman's name is Jason Funger. You can also find him on TikTok.
There's this illusion that there's these happy animals and they don't know what's going on, but watch Dominion. Watch these animals in these conditions. Look into their eyes and see what they're feeling. I hate to break it to you, but you're kidding yourself. Really, watch Dominion, watch what really happens. There's this illusion that there's these happy animals and they don't know what's going on, but watch Dominion, watch these animals in these conditions. Look into their eyes and see what they're feeling. I hate to break.
He is another teacher, just like me.
Did you know that milk comes from a cycle of violence? Watch Dairy is Scary on YouTube. It's only 5 minutes long. Drink plant milks instead. Did you know? The animals are suffering right now, and so is the planet. Thank you for watching Seaspiracy on Netflix and for becoming vegan to help us end the animal holocaust. Hello, students. When you're a new vegan, you might cook like this. This is Tabitha Brown's site. Now, I personally rarely use vegan sausages, and I don't cook in oil because cooking in oil is not healthy for you, but definitely when you cook vegan sausages and you cook it in oil, it gives it that more, well, meaty taste, let's say. What is great though is that she's showing you that you should eat vegetables that need to be eaten. You go through your fridge and just take a bit of everything. Lots of different colors there. You can also cook with some vegan cheese. You can put that in things. I personally don't because it's a processed food, but you can see she's using some mushrooms here and just whatever you want. Just add things. Have fun with it. Get lots of spices. Cumin, curry, garlic. Yummy. Hello,
students.
It looks
delicious.
Are you vegan yet? If so, fantastic. If not, what are you waiting for? Are you vegan yet? If so, fantastic. If not, what are you waiting for?
Hello. I just want to talk about oppression for a second. There are many groups that claim that they are the most oppressed group. There's one group of individuals who do not say anything, and that is the animals, because they have no spokespeople. They don't have Twitter, they don't have TikTok, they have nobody. The only people they have are animal rights activists, who are a tiny, tiny percentage. percentage of all vegans. I will be the voice of animals as a primary voice for all oppressed. I do, of course, feel for all other oppressed groups, but I will call them out as well. I have called out Black people when they abuse animals. That means eat them, wear them, pay for them as entertainment. I've done the same thing for the LGBTQ community, for feminists, all groups. Nobody's off the hook.
Including white people.
LGBTQ, we support you, but if you don't like oppression, why the fuck aren't you vegan yet? LGBTQ, we support you, but if you don't like oppression, why the fuck aren't you vegan yet?
Good question. Why is it that these oppressed groups claim that they are oppressed, but then they continue to oppress? This is what I'm curious about. When you find out that there's a group that's oppressed, why does your heart not immediately go out to them and you see them and you see yourself in them and then you think, okay, I should stop hurting these animals. They're suffering. They're being killed. They are being ripped away from their mothers. In the dairy industry, they take away baby cows and they murder them because the baby boys will not be able to give them milk. They put them in these tiny sheds and they torture them until they murder them. They forcefully impregnate mothers. That's rape. It's not okay. We must not do this to these animals. They have not done one single thing wrong to us ever. Don't hurt animals. Don't exploit them. Don't eat them. Don't wear them. Don't put them in circuses. Be kind to them. As much as possible, be kind to the pets that you have as well. Don't murder other animals and then give them to your dog. How is that being kind to animals? Cats and dogs can be vegan. If you're having trouble, go to vgrrr.com or find yourself a vegan vet who will help you with that. Granted, for cats, it's not always as easy, but it is entirely possible. There are people who have vegan cats all over the world. And why is this possible? Because it's not the meat that they need, it is the nutrients that they need. You understand? Imagine this. You pay somebody to breed an animal into existence to begin with, which is already wrong. Then you bring that animal home, a dog, and you use it like some sort of a trophy or toy. And then you go and you point at chickens, at pigs, at cows, at lambs. You say, kill that one for my dog and kill that one for my dog. Oh yeah, kill that lamb for my dog and kill that chicken and kill that pig and kill that horse for my dog. All these animals that end up in dog food makes no sense when there is a healthy option. Buy vegan dog food. Don't just give your dog a few cucumbers and a couple of pieces of celery in the grass outside. Of course not. And that's the lie that went around about me. People spread this entire crazy lie that my dog Bella, who is right over here beside me, was unhealthy. It's absolutely insane. The vets repeatedly check her out and repeatedly tell us how healthy she is. So what's the problem? It's like a no-brainer. Buy healthy vegan dog food and you can find it down in the link below. You can find all kinds of links to Challenge 22, which is how to help you to become vegan and how to get vegan dog food.
Happy vegan, happy vegan, happy vegan declaration day.
Is it your vegan declaration day today? Mine is June 27th. I became vegan on June 27th, 2016. Most people who become vegan have a hard time remembering their day because it happens so gradually, because it takes 100 clicks until you're vegan. It has to penetrate your heart. You have to feel for the animals. It has to penetrate your brain. You have to understand everything. You have to understand that it's possible to be vegan. You can't just get that message in one day like that. You have to watch an entire documentary. And you have to have time to sit with it. You have to think about the way that you have contributed to the torture. And you have to be willing to forgive yourself for all the stuff you've done in the past and admit that you want to change going forward. That's how we create a vegan world. By putting down our ego and realizing that we are no better than these other animals on the planet, that we must all work together and to do our least harm. Why are all veterinarians not vegan? How does it make sense that they eat their own patients? If you come out of vet school and you then go home to celebrate that you got your diploma by cutting it into a steak, something's fucking wrong with that. It's nuts. All vets should be vegan. All white people should be vegan. All dark people should be vegan. All fat people should be vegan. All skinny people should be vegan. All kids, all teenagers, all parents, all grandparents. Because all it means is that you do your best at all times not to harm them. It doesn't mean that you today you throw out all your leather shoes. No, because how is that going to help? You already bought them. If you throw out all the food in your fridge right now, that's not going to help. What will help is that you decide right now that you will never pay to hurt a single animal ever again. That's where you start. You go shopping, you put veggies, fruits, nuts, and seeds into your shopping cart. Peace begins on your plate, so you open up your heart. That's your job. That's why we're here on Earth, to protect the ecosystem and all the sentient beings living. Because if we ourselves were born into the body of a chicken, a pig, a cow, or a lamb, or a turkey, we would want somebody to protect us. What is the big deal? It's just obvious. If you don't believe in stealing, don't steal from the animals. Stealing is against the law, but why is it okay to steal the lives, the bodies of animals when that is the only thing they have? The only one possession they have is their own body.
Being vegan means being the change you want to see in the world. So share this song and be better. Be vegan from now on.
You can do it.
One, two, three, go. With a name like Steven, you should be vegan. With a name like Steven, you should be vegan. With a name like Steven, you should be vegan. With a name like Steven, you should be vegan. Oh, yeah. One, two, three, go. With a name like Steven, you should be vegan. With a name like Steven, you should be vegan. With a name like Steven, you should be vegan. With a name like Steven, you should be vegan. Oh, yeah.
I forgot to mention this earlier. Today is World Autism Awareness Day, since it's officially April 2nd. And let me just say this. As a person on the autism spectrum, I don't let my disability stop me from being who I am. I may have my flaws. I may make a bunch of mistakes. I may not have a big understanding of a lot of things in life. But in the end, I learn from those mistakes. I brush off the dust and I move on. Okay? I might think differently than everyone else. But in the end, I function the same way as everyone else, just from a different approach. So don't judge me for who you think I am. Judge me for my own personality and judge me for how you perceive me as once you get to know me. Thank you.
Thank you for not eating
Have
animals.
You been curious about trying plant-based eating, but not sure if you want to commit to being 100% vegan? That's okay. I know it can seem overwhelming, and sometimes veganism can seem intimidating. My advice is to start with one goal, like swapping out dairy milk for almond milk, having crispy tofu instead of chicken, or maybe having a dedicated meatless Monday. I have a ton of free recipes or a meal plan for those of you who need a little extra help. Oh, and one important thing. You're welcome to be a part of the Healthy Girl Kitchen community, whether you're vegan or not. Have you been curious about trying plant-based eating, but not sure if you want to commit to being 100% vegan? That's okay. I know.
Well, it's not okay to not commit to be 100% vegan. But at the beginning, it's all about these clicks that we got to get. We got to ease into it sometimes. There's so much to learn, right, about food. I mean, on the one hand, it's super easy. You just don't put any dead animals into your cart and you work your way backwards. You just throw everything else in there and figure out how to go forward. Some people, they just do it. Other people are just like, I don't know what to eat. So whatever works. The point is that your journey to get from meat eater to vegan should be as quick as possible. As quick as possible.
I know it can seem overwhelming.
I am not a natural athlete. Newsflash. And I've never claimed to be one either. I get so many messages from teenagers saying they're just not seeing the results and wanting to start steroids. So my answer is simple and always the same. No, Just because you see influencers glorifying gear does not mean you should take it. I personally know people who have taken vitamin S from the age of 14 and now facing serious health issues. I don't want that to happen to you. Just because I've done it does certainly not mean you should too. I work alongside professionals and doctors to get the best advice and regular tests. Your health and hormones matter, and that's my best advice to teens. I am not a natural athlete.
Great. Your health matters. And you can be healthy no matter what stage of development you are. And there are vegan bodybuilders in this world. There are many of them. Simply Google vegan athletes.
Carrots and hummus, cucumbers and hummus, peppers and hummus, broccoli and hummus. Won't you please be kind to us and be vegan from now on?
Eat your veggies.
What is carnism? Carnism is a dominant belief system. This means that it's so widespread that its principles and practices are considered common sense, the way things are, rather than a set of widely held opinions. Carnistic bias, therefore, remains unseen. For example, most people aren't aware that when they study nutrition, they're actually studying carnistic nutrition.
What this means is that the doctors who go to school in the... Oh, there's Bella. The doctor, I think that's our delivery of our loofah. We get some veggies delivered every week in a giant container. And half the time we don't even know what we're going to get. And it's great because you just open it up and you go, okay, what's this? Oh, let's Google that and let's find a way to cook down the recipe. Hey, Bella. Bella, come here. It's okay. Come. You want to say hi to everybody? No? Okay. She's not finished yet. She's going to go check again. Yo, it's about that time to bring forth the rhythm and the rhyme. Always get mine, so get yours. I want to see sweat coming out your pores. All right. Yo, so here we have somebody that says, so we're talking about being kind to Asian people here. We should not be discriminating against anyone regardless of their skin color. Black lives matter, Asian lives matter, all lives matter. I know people don't like it when I say that, but it's the truth. All lives matter. We are all related and we must all be kind to each other. Discrimination is wrong, including discriminating against animals. Friends, not food. Turkeys are friends, not food. Fish, pigs. Oh, there's two turkeys here. And cow. All deserve to be treated with dignity and respect. We shouldn't hurt anyone unless it is in self-defense. Unless we absolutely have to and there's no other choice. Just the same as if you were attacking me, I would save myself. Okay, so that's normal. But if there's a store nearby, go to the store. Don't pay somebody money to kill an innocent animal that didn't do anything wrong to you.
Animals are innocent like children. They need protection. Save them now. Save them now.
Because when they come out to their families and friends, many times they're rejected. Not to mention that they are often the target of heightened amounts of bullying in school. Because when they come out to their families and friends, many times they're rejected. Not to mention that they are often the target of heightened amounts of bullying in school.
Now this gentleman, his name is John Robert Bell. What I did is I took his words. He's talking about homophobia. But what I am showing here in this video is that his exact language could also apply for vegan kids. Vegan phobia is real. Vegan kids are bullied. And that is what I am showing in this in order to try to enlighten him. Because he is not vegan. In fact, he laughs at vegans and thinks it's funny to make fun of them and has encouraged his millions of followers on TikTok to go ahead, keep paying for the rape, the torture, the kidnapping, and the murder of innocent animals. He is a disgrace. He should be deplatformed for what he has done. So I took his very words here and I'm trying to show him that the same is true. Homophobia is wrong and vegan phobia is wrong. And watch the next video.
Ethical vegan kids are consistently terrified to come out of the closet for fear of being bullied by people of all ages, including their peers, parents, and teachers. Ethical vegan kids are consistently terrified to come out of the closet for fear of being bullied by people of all ages, including their peers, parents, and teachers.
This is what is being read here. Then it says, vegan teens are often hit if they refuse to eat dead animals. They are kicked out of the house. This is what happens. How do I know? I have seen it myself here on TikTok when I have seen the duets that people have done. They have said straight out, if my kid ever becomes vegan, I'm kicking them out of the house. Can you imagine? You have raised a kid who is absolutely the most caring person possible, the least selfish person on earth, and you're going to reward that child's beautiful heart by treating him like a piece of shit? You are a piece of shit if you do that. If you have a child who comes out of the closet and says, I was born vegan, I know it, I never wanted to hurt animals, I never wanted you to put these animals inside of me, I never consented to that, I did not agree, I did not know that you were killing these animals for me, and now I want to go back to the way I was. We were all born vegan, it's time to return. If you have a teenager or a child who says that to you, your only job is to have a gigantic smile on your face, and your arms should open wide and embrace your child and say, I am so proud of you. You are amazing. And then you go shopping together. And what do you put in your shopping cart? Veggies, fruits, nuts, and seeds. Put them in your shopping cart because peace begins on your plate. And so you need to open up your heart to the animals and to your child. And if it is your husband that wants to be vegan, same thing. Honey, I'm so proud of you. If it's your wife, oh my God, sweetie, I'm so proud of you. Let's do this as a family. That's your job. That's your job. You should be so proud if you know anybody who's an ethical vegan. I'm not talking about vegans who go to yoga and say namaste, and then they go ahead and just, you know, eat eggs and stuff like that whenever they feel like it. That's not being vegan. A vegan is somebody who cares about the animals and will not eat them no matter what and will speak out on their behalf all the time. If you say, oh, I know lots of vegans and they're not mean like you, they're not outspoken like you, well, they're not really vegan, because the whole point of being vegan is to care about the animals. And if you see them being exploited, if you see them dead on a plate, your job is to say, there's a dead animal here. When you go to the grocery store, you walk up to the clerks and you say, excuse me, did you know that there's dead animals in here? Like, what the fuck's going on in your store? That's what you do. If you're standing at the cash and you see somebody buying a dead lamb, you say, oh my God, did you realize that there's a dead lamb right here on the counter? Like, what the fuck? Why are you buying that? That's your job. Yeah. I know. I know what you're thinking, but that's your job. All right, so this is TikTok today. Thank you very much for joining me today on this little journey into what's going on Facebook today. You can subscribe to this channel if you want to. 91 followers, woohoo! But you don't need to, because the whole point is that there is going to be a presence of that vegan teacher on TikTok always. Always there will be an account there, whether it's taken down or not. That's beyond my control. What is in my control is that I can keep going back and I can keep showing the world that it's important. And all of you, when your accounts are banned, keep going back. Because we have a responsibility to speak out on behalf of the animals, and this has a great algorithm in which to do that. You could stand up. Okay, you see this video only has 39 views. That's because this one was put in the holding tank for a while. Whenever there's a black person and people are trying to talk about something to do with racism, TikTok always just puts it in the holding tank, like, oh my God, maybe this is going to be racist. But you see, they let it go. They saw the message and they thought, okay, she's just trying to give this view. White, and here's folks, what's happening.
Do y'all really love me?
Speciesism is...
Okay, so he says, y'all folks, do y'all really love me? So he has tears coming down his eyes and he's saying, yo, white folks, do you love me? And it's like, I don't know you. Maybe I could love you. I don't know. And so here's what it says. Speciesism is the purest form of racism. Skin color has nothing to do with love.
Is the purest form of racism. Skin color has nothing to do with love. Do you pay people to enslave and murder animals just for your taste pleasure? Be vegan, no matter what your skin color is.
White folks, do y'all really love me?
Now, the strangest thing that's going on TikTok, there's this competition about being able to to show that you can cry and then just say something. Like, it's some acting challenge. It's weird. So I'm benefiting from this. The fact that this guy is saying, yo, white people, do y'all really love me? Like, what does your skin color have to do with anything? What I'm looking at is the strength of your character, whether you're white, purple, green, orange, I don't care what your skin color is. What's in your shopping cart? If you have dead body parts in there, no, I don't love you. I will never love somebody who pays for murder. How can you love a murderer? To love somebody means to respect them and to want to be like them. I don't want to be like somebody who hurts animals. I have the potential in me to love people who care about animals and who are kind to them. And you should too. And if you love people that murder animals, that pay for chickens to be in tight, confined spaces where they can't even open their wings, and where they lay eggs that go immediately on a conveyor belt, and when they are hatched and they're boys and they are put into a grinder because they will never be able to lay eggs, that's not love when you allow somebody like that into your life without telling them firmly, these are my boundaries. You cannot eat dead animals around me. This is my boundary. I will not condone this. Let's eat vegan food together. I know it's hard because vegan phobia exists, but it's our responsibility. So thank you to everybody who has participated in checking out TikTok today. If you are not yet vegan, I encourage you to do so. And if you have not yet subscribed, please subscribe to this channel. I am That Vegan Teacher, Miss Katie. It's spelled K-A-D-I-E. And you can find me also on Instagram. And in the links below, you will find all kinds of links to vegan pet food and to challenge22.com, which is something you should join. It's going to help you. You have free help from dietitians and you're in a group and they coach you along to become vegan in 22 days. It's great. Really, try it. And if you don't believe me about what's going on, please watch dominionmovement.com like Jason tried to tell you in this video here. Watch dominion.com. Thank you all for being here, and thank you to my patrons who are helping me out on Patreon. It is so appreciated. Thank you to the moderators who are here, who are my teaching assistants, who help in the comment section to teach what I am unable to always do. I am so busy on many different platforms, and these students are just awesome. Truly awesome. Thank you all so much. I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now. Oh, we forgot, almost forgot the hug. Don't forget to hug yourself. Why are you hugging yourself? Because you're the only one who can consistently be here. People come and go in our lives, but we are always here. And we must always treat ourselves nicely. Put your hand around little you, 5-year-old you going into kindergarten, who is so innocent and pure and who never wanted to hurt an animal, and give the person a squeeze. And look at yourself and feed yourself only healthy things. Get exercise, get some sun on your cheeks. Be sweet with yourself, be seriously nice to yourself. If you saw yourself right now, your 5-year-old self, wouldn't you just want to just go, oh my God, you're so cute. And oh my God, I love you. Okay? So love yourself. Get up. Stand up proud. Be better. And be vegan from now on. Thank you.